EA Sports, it's in the game. Yep, you've got one guy going boom, the other guy going rap, and the guy trying to run it in for the score, and he's going nowhere.
Opened back in 2003, have a look at the link. Lincoln Financial Field, where 70,000 are rocking and ready to go in Philadelphia. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl. And we've got a classic in store between the New Orleans Saints and the Philadelphia Eagles. One of these teams will represent the NFC in the Super Bowl in 2 weeks' time. Which will it be as we're underway in the NFC title game? And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. They'll go play action. Howell. And his first look is incomplete.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Yeah, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. First carry now for the LSU alum, Ty Davis Price. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Third play here on this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. They go play action with Howell. Gets it out wide to Davis Price. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
I'm not sure that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Gonna run again here with Pollard. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Faking the handoff, Howell. He'll get that complete to Alvaro. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down. We got to like what you're seeing from this offense here on the first drive. A nice, sustained series to begin the game. It will continue after picking up another first there.
Did you say the word methodical?
Davis Price hit, and he fumbles it. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. And in this very cold night air, how much harder, Charles, is it to hang on to that football?
It's a lot harder, and I know for the most part we think about a ball being slick when there's rain or snow, any type of moisture. But when it's cold and dry like this,
it is cold.
It's also slick that way because you're not able to really grip it the same way. Your hands are cold, and then the hits seem harder. So, yeah, it's a lot more difficult to hold on to the football, which means you have to emphasize it that much more.
Wind chills right now, 12 degrees. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10.
Easy. 21.
Running from the gun with Henry. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about 4.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing on third down, Stafford. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. Call it a gain of a yard, and that'll bring up fourth down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Snap it to Stafford. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And this defense will take over right at midfield. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. That good for 19 and a first down.
A big hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that run could go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
First down, and they go right back to Davis Price. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and are controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Off play action. It's out. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. On third down, here's Davis Price. And he's going to get this to the 31, but that is still well short of what he needed. Giving 3 yards there as that'll take us to fourth down. The kick by Lutz is good, and the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. So after drive number 3 here, we have a score, and it's 3 points after the field goal.
I would say the feeling out process for both these teams, I'd say it's over, partner. Everyone understands what's going on now. You've kind of probed a little bit. Now you want to start throwing the big shots. First 3 points up on the board could be significant.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They're coming off a fourth down gamble that last drive that backfired, CD, but really not as badly as it could. Their defense held up and only gave up 3 points.
And what they wanted to do is play off the momentum the defense gave them. Only giving up the 3 points in that situation after they failed on fourth down. Now they want to make it pay off. They want to pay homage to the defense and have their own drive pay off in points for themselves.
3-0 after one on EA Sports. Second and 6, just inside the 30. Give. Now Stafford. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Absolutely no disguise on that one. They just went for it. Put him out there and said, go deep. Let's try and hit him. Unfortunately, to no avail.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and 6.
Hey,
To throw is Stafford. Flush to his right. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
Here we go on fourth. Stafford got a man. That's Colin Johnson. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. To throw, Stafford forced out to his left and eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. It looks like a 12-yard loss there on the first down sack.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Meanwhile, Stafford's throw taken in by Watkins here. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there, perfectly executed crossing route. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. In motion right here comes Johnson. From the gun on 3rd down, Stafford. And that will be incomplete.
2 drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get on track in this one.
Stafford going deep here for Watkins. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. It's Tariq Castro-Fields who picked it. And the Saints are going to take over at their own 41. So they tried to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got 5 big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
On the stop there defensively, Marcus May with a tackle. 2nd down, and again, it's Davis Price. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. And obviously, they want that run yardage, so they decline the penalty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Smart on their part. They finished off the play. But if you're going to jump, if you're going to commit a penalty, it's your job to finish off the play so you don't give up big gains like that.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
They'll send the tight end in motion. 2nd down, here's Davis Price. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. He's already fumbled once in this game, and I thought the ball started to jostle there a little bit, but they got to him quickly at the line of scrimmage.
They sure did, and remember, if you're not a very confident runner, and you've already dropped it once, if there's traffic around you, the only thing you think about is protecting the football, not gaining yards.
Going for it, here's Davis Price. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. 90 yards rushing for him now. A strong performance here this first half with a Super Bowl berth on the line. Now they bring a receiver in motion right. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Tony Pollard taking it in from 4 yards out as his guys are able to extend their lead. Lutz with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This one fielded at the 5.
The Eagles take over first down at their own 30-yard line.
The line, this Philly offense set to go.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive, in particular if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Johnson, the man in motion right. Second down, they go again with Henry. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
A first down carry for Henry. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get 3 out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense? The next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Play action. Stafford. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's Tariq Castro Fields who picked it. And the Saints are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And he will step out of bounds all the way down inside the 40. 130 yards rushing for him now in the ball game as he goes over the century mark with the AFC title on the line. Davis Price on first and 10. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them. Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. The play fake, and now here's Hal to throw it.
Rolling to his left.
He gets this one to Davis Price.
And a good tackle there right around the 30, stops him short of the first down. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. He made his first, this from 47 yards out. The kick by Lutz is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've reached halftime here in the NFC Championship as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3.
Will Lutz to kick off quarter one.
The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway in the NFC Championship game. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they have work to do in this second half if they want to earn that berth to the Super Bowl.
And I'm pretty sure this is where their coaches at halftime were saying don't panic, and then demonstrating it by not making a lot of drastic changes to the game plan. Let's just get back to doing what we've been doing all year long. That should be more than good enough.
I'd say it's pretty good strategy. If you throw interceptions on back-to-back drives, let's see if the running backs can handle the ball a little bit, get things going, and also you motivate your offensive line. I think they're in the mood to fire out and hit someone.
I thought the defense, though, might be a little more prepared for that run. Pretty good gain on the ground.
Henry again on second down. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Tenth carry now for Derrick Henry. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
From the lineman to the guy running with it, that was a well-executed first down by the offense. With 2 shots left to get the first, you can get a little aggressive here on second down if you want and try for some bigger yardage.
And the tight end goes in motion left. On second down, here's Henry. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Well, when you go from 2nd and 4 to 3rd and 3, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, 2nd round the defense.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or 2 shy of the 40. 71 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
On first down at Stafford. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Calvin Ridley, 42 yards.
And the Eagles are back within a score. Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now 13-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least 3 here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try and make sure that momentum stays in your camp.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3-and-out here and get the football right back because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And this time, he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
Try the right side, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Second down, Powell. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety back all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
An incomplete pass on second down. It muddles things a little bit here. This is 3rd and 10. They'll run left with Pollard. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The slot man in motion right. So here we go, 4th down, Howell. And it's incomplete, they cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it, doesn't pan out, and the Eagles are gonna take over in great field position. In motion, the tight end. Now a first down throw, Stafford. Going up top for Kupp. On Stafford for the 3rd time is intercepted. It's Tariq Castro-Fields who picked it. And the Saints force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles. And I believe it's against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
We're in the third quarter of the NFC title game. This is second and 10. And Howell will throw it. That's complete. It's Okwuegbunam. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Gets this one to Hill. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. An effective 7 yard third down conversion.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
One quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL. Been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. On second and 12, Powell being chased out left, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The offense on third down tonight, they've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This will be third and forever. Third and long, here's Howell. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Give him 19 on the play, but they will still come up a bit short. And now it's fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Gets it out quickly here to the left flat. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
This game has been a lesson, a clinic in how to throw the football. I mean, even with a big lead, they're not turning off the engine. They're not getting off the gas at all. They plan to keep going at them, and it's working for them.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15. Now they will run it with Davis Price.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I think as a running back in this spot, you have to understand there's not going to be a whole lot of room to run. And in this case, ball protection takes precedent over trying to make something happen.
Second down, and again, it's Davis Price.
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
An open man, it's short, and he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and that's going to make it fourth down. So here we go, maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to perhaps salt this one away. The kick by Lutz is good, and now it's a 2-score game at 9, 16-7.
So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down 2 scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
The line, this Philly offense set to go. Monday. With 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
The pass there over the middle to start things out. Finding room at midfield. Stafford now to throw. Buying time to his left. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Stafford. Over the middle, complete. That's Watkins. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they are fully in sync. 3 straight passes, 3 first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost at will. This defense really struggling to find answers.
Now Stafford. Eluding the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick success.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
And the Saints are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line.
All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to 7. If we'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Second down, and again it's Davis Price. And only able to get 2 here, stopped at the 30. The Saints are the champions of the NFC. As we say thank you for watching,